Wouldn't it be nice that when you come to a chair, you're out of the elevator and you find some interactive information? This is exactly what I thought when I designed the Infoscreen in 2008. And what you see here is an interactive information display. First of all, the Infoscreen is a hardware. And when designing the hardware, the idea was to have something that looks cool when it's hanging in the hallway where it's currently hanging. And in 2008, there were these ambilight TVs, and so the idea was to use such an ambilight TV. But we also wanted to have touch. And so the first thing was creating an ambilight TV with touch. So we bought an ambilight TV and we bought a touch panel and we bought a computer that should drive the entire thing, and then everything got mounted together by Richard. And as you can see here and also in the video, it has a very nice ambient glow effect right now. It really looks spectacular where the screen is hanging, and here you can see where it's hanging inside the building. And unlike other screens, it really has this nice aura around it. When no one is interacting with the system, then it's just showing a slideshow. So when people approach, they see, okay, something is happening. And what you can do is you can touch the screen and then things happen. So here at the bottom, you see all the current staff members and you can just click them, and then you can see pages that they set up before. You can interact with the pages. On my page you can, for instance, see the student office that I have at the moment. This is actually the original mock-up that I made in 2008 for the Infoscreen. You already see some elements there, and well, what we currently see is the automatic slideshow that is running. And you can always just touch the screen and then you jump to the interface that we have here. So I give you a quick tour starting on the top left. So on the top left we have the logo, we have the name of the chair, we have a running text that can be configured, I will show you in a second how. We have the current date and time, we have the upcoming talks, at the bottom we have the staff members, and on the left we have the current staff member shown, with room number, telephone number, email address and name. And then we have two information pages here. And what was important was that the Infoscreen doesn't produce overhead for the staff members. And what you can do here is you can just configure any website you want and it's then shown within those iframes here. So in my case, I just put some information about my research and my currently open thesis, plus a QR code if the students want to scan this. On the right, you can click on all these events that we have, and what happens is that you get to a page where I put all the upcoming talks. So this is our event page. Down here, you can just click on a staff member, and then you see the information about this particular staff member. How to configure this. So as backend, we use a type of 3 system, and to show you what I said before, that when you click on someone and it reaches the page of this someone that is shown, I go to our website, it looks like this one here, and now I just go to Haensch, and here you see, okay, this is his website. And this is exactly what is shown here. And on the other side, by default, just some information about the chair is shown, so actually this is just our start page that is shown. Okay, so for me you see that I configured different pages, and I will show you how this is possible. So inside the type of 3 we use the address database here, and so this is my data, and system uses the pictures that I uploaded here, It displays everyone who is part of the Infoscreen group. And once you're part of the Infoscreen group, you can just configure the pages that should be shown on the Infoscreen. But here I could also put other pages, and then they would just be shown. Other things we can configure is the text and the speed of the text up here. And to do so, we just have a Typo3 page that is shown here. So this is our Infoscreen config. And here you see the text that is shown on the top, and you should see the delays, how fast it is. Plus, you see the setup of what is shown on the right bar. So this is parsing our RSS feed and then showing the data from the RSS feed.
You can check which are the current Oberseminar dates.
Yeah, what's the next?
Yeah, you are also on the list.
Yeah, but these changes were not like scheduled.
September, final interpretation.
Yeah, in September.